What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. In this video, we're going to be unboxing, assembling, and doing the first print on the CR-10S. Now that the CR-10 is out of the box, what you're wanting to do is find the toolbox. Inside of the toolbox, there's going to be many, many things. Put them all off to the side. But right this minute, you're just interested in one bag that contains the snips. For safety and security, the CR-10S comes with zip ties all over it. Now using your new snips, cut all of these off. With the Z-axis freed, now take off the last of the packaging and let's move on to assembly. Before we continue, along with this video, remember to use the instructions as things may change in the future. Having said that, my first tip is to start with the T-brackets, unlike the instructions say, because this will make it much easier to align the T-nuts later on. Don't be fooled by the name, as in this bag contains the bolts that we will need to fix the Z-axis to the body later. For now, put those bolts to one side and let's get to know the T-brackets. There is a left one and a right one. The left one has the limit switch. Keep that in mind. Now prepare your work area, as things are going to get fiddly. Keep in mind when you're lifting up the frame not to put pressure on the Z-screws. Wherever you place the frame back down, put it down like this. Once your work area is set, grab your T-brackets, your left and your right. Now remember, the backside of the printer has the motor on the back. We're going to start on the left side, but both of these are pretty much the same. Now grab your bag of tools and get the Allen keys out. You may want to get the very little Allen key, as that might come in handy in what's to come. Now say hello to the T-nuts. These things are a real pain, as you need them to turn clockwise 90 degrees to lock inside of the T-bar. Put them horizontally, slot them in, and turn the Allen key to the right. This may turn the nut, and that's it. However, if it doesn't, jiggle about, have a go, use the small Allen key, see if that gets them to twist. In my case, nothing was working. In that case, what you do is you take it off, take the T-nuts off, and then put them in manually, one by one. To do it manually, you're going to need pliers. What you're trying to achieve here is to get the T-nut at a 45 degree angle to then be able to do the last little twist with the pliers. Now pliers aren't always needed. As you can see, my second T-nut was done by hand. Now space your T-nuts equally to fit the new T-bracket onto your newly fitted T-nuts. This part is crucial. Make sure that your T-nuts are still vertical inside of the T-bar. If they're not vertical, you're going to have to go back a step and repeat till this is done correctly. Tighten the bolt so it's securely fastened but still movable. Do the exact same process on the other side and now move the T-brackets close to where the holes are where you're going to be attaching the gantry. Now loosen the two top nuts of each T-bracket and place them horizontally to make it a lot easier to put the top gantry on and making sure that they are horizontal inside of the T-slot. Now, with the extruder facing you, we are going to slowly but surely put the Z-gantry on top of the T-brackets, making sure that the T-nuts enter the T-slots in a horizontal position. This can be a bit tricky and fiddly, but once done, just loosely tighten the bolts, because we're going to need a little bit of play for the next part. It's now time to prepare the bolts to attach your Z gantry to the base. These are in that misnamed bag I showed you earlier. From here, carefully and still holding the printer, move your CR-10 just slightly off the table, and slowly but surely move the top gantry till the holes align underneath and fix the bolts in through the bottom. Once you've done this to both sides, you're almost there. Just finish tightening up both T-bracket screws to a reasonable stiffness. That's it for the main structural assembly. Now let's tackle these wires. Thankfully, Creality have made this really easy by labeling every single wire. Technically, there's only two connections you need to worry about here, which is the 4-pin stepper motor connections and the 3-pin limit switch connectors. I would suggest following the instructions for this, as they've made it really simple to follow. But in a nutshell, you look at the cable, see the axis it's correlated to, then find where that motor is using the instructions, plug it into the motor, plug it into the limit switch if there is a limit switch, and that's it. Do that for all the motors and limit switches, and all that's left is the extruder and the filament sensor, which is this cable, by the way, which you don't have to plug in if you don't want it. Quick tip, keep in mind where these cables are going to be placed in the future. It might have to go under the frame. While we're connecting all these wires, we might as well connect the bowden tube. Just plug it in and make sure it's secure by pulling this out. You may have noticed I haven't taught you how to install the racing stripes. That's because I can't deal with this, and I'm all about the pure, sleek goodness. Finally, we're just left with two power cables, one for the bed, one for the head. Follow the instructions, you can't even plug these in wrong. However, one thing you can have very wrong is having the voltage input wrong. Double check this, and double check it again, because you can fry your motherboard. Once you know your voltage input is set correctly, get your power cable, plug it in, and turn this beast on. I'm not planning on going in too much detail with the menus, but this screen here is where you'll be able to realize if anything is broken. Your thermostats should show 0 at the top, and underneath that should show the temperature of what it is naturally. If it is 0 on the bottom, that means that the thermostat for your bed or your head is broken. I've kept the film on my bed this entire time to protect it more than anything. The first thing we need to do now is hit auto home. This will then let us move the axes to then be able to remove the bed. Once the printer is homed, you'll be able to move the axes safely. Go into the move menus and move the Z axis using the 1mm setting upwards to then let you remove the bed. Removing the bed is easy. Just move that axis and then remove the clips, take the bed off, and take off the tape that's underneath. Remove the film that's on it, and here's where the controversy starts. I'm going to tell you not to put anything on your bed. The main thing most people are doing wrong here, and why they have bad adhesion, is because they don't completely clean their bed before use. You may be tempted to use alcohol while washing the bed. Don't do this, as it leaves a layer of hydrocarbons on the surface, which means that your adhesion will be really bad. On top of that, make sure that your fingers never touch the glass once it's been washed. Now your bed is almost ready to be printed on. It just needs to be leveled. Grab yourself a piece of paper 0.1mm thick. I'm using the instruction manual here. Go into the menus and find auto bed leveling. What your plan is here is to tighten and loosen the bed controls underneath the bed to have the bed not bite the paper but just feel the smallest amount of friction. Each time you feel this, hit next or go back into auto leveling and hit next step until you've done it to all the points. Now let's load some filament. The first step is to preheat the printer. That's under settings, PLA, preheat. Then we're going to put together the spool holder while it's heating up. The spool holder is easy. It's two screws, this metal part, this plastic bit, twist it together, put the spool on it, then feed the filament through the bowden tube until it reaches the head. At this point, wait till the PLA preheat gets up to temperature, the same as the other move settings, go into 1mm, go to the extruder, and just give it a couple of millimeters to see that the filament is running smoothly. Once you see this, you know that the printer is working beautifully, and it's now time to set up your first print. I'm going to keep this as quick and simple as possible. I'm going to show you both Cura and Simplify 3D. To start, the model we'll be printing is the 3D Benchy, as you'll learn the most from this print. Learn more about it on the website down in the description. Now that you have your file, let's start with Cura. It's as simple as starting up the program, telling it which printer you have, and then editing the settings to make it how you wish you want to print. For PLA, I like to use 210 for the first layer, or 215, and then for the bed, I like to use a temperature between 60 and 70, depending on the ambient temperature. Once you're done in the prepare window, head over to preview. From here, just save it onto the microSD, and you're done. In Simplify 3D, it's pretty much just the same. Tell it that you're using a CR-10S, and from there, drop in the Benchy, change any settings that you want in the processes, so back to 210 and 70 or 60 for the bed, and then just save out the file. Now you truly are on the last leg. All you have to do is plug in the microSD, move into the bottom menu to load up the SD, find your file, and hit go. From there, just enjoy your printing. Once your print is printed, the best practice is to hit cooldown. Let it all cool down, plate and all. Then take your plate off, and then use the lovely included scraper to just slide it under the print. It should just pop right off. And lo and behold, you have now unboxed, set up, and done your first print. There you guys have it. That's how to put together a CR-10S and how to get your first print out of it. And remember, keep making and let the quest continue.